Hi dear students, welcome to my class. This is for 10th students and the chapter is metals and non-metals. In the last class we were discussed about four exercise questions, okay. In this class I am going to discussing remaining questions, that is question number 5. So we have question number 5 like this. You are given a hammer, battery, a bulb, wires and a switch. So in that option A, so A question is there, sub question A. How could you use them to distinguish between samples of metals and non-metals? So we know the general properties of metal. By using that general properties and these instruments, you have to classify the samples into metals and non-metals. First I am using a hammer. For this, using a hammer, how can you tell whether it is a metal or non-metal? So metals can be drawn into or beaten into thin sheets. So this property we call as a malleability. What ma? Malleable. Okay. So by using hammers, we can metals can made into thin sheets without breaking them. Okay. And non-metals cannot be beaten with a hammer to form thin sheets. We cannot use the same malleable property for non-metals. Only metals can follow the malleable property. So metals using this hammer, metals can made into thin sheets. Non-metals cannot made into thin sheets. Okay. So this is what by using hammer. And one more thing. Non-metals break into pieces when hammered. So if you hit the non-metals using this hammer, that non-metals are break into pieces, but metals are malleable, while non-metals are non-malleable. When metals are connected to circuit using a battery, so this battery, okay, by using this battery, metals are connected with the battery, bulb and wires and a switch, current pass through the circuit and bulb glows. Okay. So when you connect this metals into this battery, bulb glows with the help of wires and switch is on, current is passed through the circuit and the bulb is not light up at all. Metals are good conductors of electricity. So from these activity we know that metals are good conductor of electricity and non-metals are bad conductors of electricity. Okay. So wires, bulb and a battery and a switch, all these instruments used for make a circuit. From that circuit we know that in metals electricity is passed. When electricity is passed through the wires, when a switch is on, at the time a bulb is glows. Okay. This is what A for the answer. Okay. Next B is there, ma. So B is, assess the usefulness of the these tests in distinguish between metals and non-metals. So what is the use of things are classified into metals and non-metals? So the answer is like that, because of malleability, metals can be cast or casted in sheets and metals are good conductors of electricity. So these can be used for electrical cables. From the property of these metals, so these metals are used for the cables or making of wires. Okay. Next is sixth question. What are amphoteric oxides? Give two examples of amphoteric oxide. Our answer is like, so those metal oxides which show basic as well as acidic behavior are known as amphoteric oxides. Okay. So amphoteric means these are metal oxides. These metal oxides which shows a basic as well as acidic. That means these metal oxides shows both basic and acidic behavior. That type of oxides we call as amphoteric oxides. Okay, in other words, we can tell as metal oxides that reacts with both acids and bases to form salt and water. Okay, metal oxides that react with both base and acids to form salt and water. This is also called as amphoteric oxides. And one more thing, aluminium oxide, that is Al2O3, aluminium oxide and zinc oxide, ZnO, aluminium oxide and zinc oxide, okay, so are amphoteric in nature. So can you I am giving examples for this amphoteric oxide, Al2O3. Okay, so this Al2O3, that means aluminium oxide reacts with the acid, that is HCl, so which gives 2AlCl3. This is a aluminium chloride salt, that is in aqueous state, and 3 moles of water, and the same Al2O3, that means aluminium oxide, reacts with bases to NaOH. Here NaOH is base and HCl is acid, right? Now, so which gives 2NaAlO2, that is sodium aluminate, okay, and water. So this is the first example for amphoteric oxide. Next is zinc oxide. So this zinc oxide reacts with HCl. Zinc oxide reacts with HCl to form zinc chloride, ZnCl2 plus water. Next, the same zinc oxide reacts with a base, NaOH, okay, which gives Na2ZnO2 plus water. Okay, this is the answer for sixth question. Okay, next is seventh. So seventh question is like that: name two metals which will displace hydrogen from dilute acids, and two metals which will not. That means this question is based on chemical reactivity series. Okay, so the first one, metals above hydrogen, hydrogen I written a symbol H in the activity series like sodium Na and magnesium Mg. Sodium and magnesium can displace the hydrogen from dilute acids. But in the second question is there now. So the metals which cannot displaces the hydrogen, which metals cannot displaces the hydrogen, that means metals below the hydrogen in the activity series like copper Cu and silver Ag do not displace the hydrogen. Why? Because this sodium and magnesium are more reactive than hydrogen, but this copper and silver less reactive than hydrogen. That's why more reactive elements or more reactive metals can displace as the less reactive metals or less reactive elements. But less reactive elements are metals which cannot displace as the more reactive. So answer is like this. Okay, this is about 7th. Okay, next 8th question. Next is 8th question. Okay. In the electrolytic refining of a metal, electrolytic refining of metal, that is M, what would you take as anode and the cathode, and the electrolyte. So in the last videos we were discussed this electrolytic refining. Okay, in that cathode is a pure metal. Let's see that video. Okay, electrolytic refining, then only you can understand that anode impure metal. Okay, and electrolyte is which salt solution or which electrode you have to take, metal salt solutions. In that I am taking copper sulfate CuSO4. I take this copper sulfate as electrolyte in that electrolytic refining of copper. Okay, copper electrodes I am taking, that's why copper sulfate is taking. Okay, so this is all about today's class. In this class I was discussed 4 questions up to from 5 to 8 I completed in this video. Okay, in the next video I will solve remaining 4 questions. Okay, namma, thank you.